Oh, I'm M.K. Davis. I'd like to spend a little time with you to discussing some photos that I've been sent from the USSR, the old former USSR, Russia, and some hominidologists over there. They're part of the Department of Hominidology. I hope I'm saying that right. Igor Bortsev and Dmitry Bayanov, and they were kind enough to send me these photos to take a look at in the way of enhancements. And I wanted to kind of do a little rundown on these photos and what I think they are of. And, you know, I'll start with, I'll just give you a look at them. Okay. Now here's one of the photos, and the subject of the photo is off in the distance under this tree right here, in this area right here. So the task at hand would be to zoom in and then to brighten up so that you can see what exactly it is. And I was able to do that, and pretty significantly, and it was very interesting, to say the least. And these photos were taken in Siberia. And there was a number of individuals there present who witnessed this event. And photographically, I'm going to take a look at it. Let's just zoom in on this particular picture. Now there's the subject, if you can spot him there, the hair, the fur, or whatever you want to call that, right in this area right here, and it's kind of down beneath the tree, hunkered down. Now, you know, what I did to the photo was to brighten it, and it's kind of funny, but let me go back down. I don't know what the original was. Let me reload it. To do this type of enhancement, you have to have all the variations of this photo, all the elements at the same amount of zoom. Okay, so this is at 37%. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a digital split. Now, you know, filtration has always been used in photography to enhance. And you have various reasons to filter something. You might want to filter out the chromatic aberration, you know, where the defects in the lens that contribute to unsharpness. But in this case, this is a pretty sharp photo. So, you know, I'm more interested in brightening up the shadows. Okay, so there's a couple of ways you can filter or split an image up. One way is with RGB, red, green, and blue, which is with a view to looking at how it's displayed on the monitor. And then there's another way, which was looking at it with a view of how I'm going to print it out and how to mix the inks. And that would be cyan, magenta, yellow, and then black, which... when you say black, it means all tones below a certain value, you know, in brightness, so that the computer would want to mix black ink for that tone. So let's do that. I'll split it CMYK, and I see if make sure you can see that. Okay, here we go. Now the first thing you see here is a much brighter image, and that's all the subdued tones that would be mixed as black. And it's separated out from the picture. You see the other tones, the yellows, magentas, cyan. I'm just going to dump them. Don't want those right now. Let's just get these subdued tones up here where you can see them. And let's zoom in on them. And I think this is at, 37%, so I'll have to return to that. Here we go. So, can you see a difference? Now, of course, you can also carry this a little higher. So, now, it really, it's not telling me a lot more in this particular photo because the subject is in a posture such as that he's really not, you know, the brightening of it really doesn't tell me anymore. But what I wanted to do was go through this with you. And now I'll go to, back to the list of photos. And I should have some that are... Here is a an animation with all the first five frames. And I'm going to open it up in an animator. There we go. And you'll see this individual, there he is right there, in five different shots, and these people took photos in rapid succession. So I was able to make a little movie out of it, and I was able to brighten it up, and you see what a tremendous difference it made. Okay. Pretty interesting now, isn't it? You can actually see it up under that tree, in the shadows of that tree. And you know what kind of fascinated me about it. Is this right here? We'll just kind of zoom in on it. That it's got, at first I thought this was like a hoodie with hair hanging out, but at that distance, the individual strands of head hair are hard to see. Because, I mean, this is a tremendous zoom. But this is actually the beard. And the beard is of a much lighter color than the hair on the rest of the body. So that it's got actually a tasseled, long tasseled, kind of a raggedy, stringy, reddish blonde beard. Now, let's just go back to our enhancement program. And I'm going to go take a different frame, and this will be frame number 2. Okay, here we go, and I'm going to split it off. Let me go. I'm sorry, I forgot to return the camera. Go back to the wide field. Okay, now I'm going to dump the cyan, magenta, and yellow. And I'm going to boost the brightness on this one. And then I'm going to cut it. And then I'm going to take it back to the original. And I'm going to paste it as an object. In other words, it's going to be a layer over what you see there. There it is. Now I'm going to go to the transparency tool. And I'm going to make it about 30% transparent. Okay, it's about 30. You see some of the color come back. But what I want to do is to maintain that brightness, but still regain some of the color information on the photo. So I'm going to merge those two. Then I'm going to go up here to hue and saturation and work on the regaining the color some more. And there you go. Now you see the colors aren't dark. They're bright. You kind of get the best elements of both. All I've done is change the balance of the photo so that the brightness is improved. Now it's going to make all this snow and stuff look washed out. But this is not a tourist photo. We're interested in this right here. So that's what we're going to go to. Now we're going to zoom in on that and see if I'm able to improve things. Oh, yes. Now you're going to see the beard right in here. You're going to see hair flowing off the back of the head. Long hair. Long hair here. And what's even more surprising is you're going to see the eye right here. And I'm going to kind of zoom in on that eye. There it is, right here. And that's a very unusually large eye. It's large, and it brings to mind what some people, native peoples, call a Sasquatch or Bigfoot. Over here in the States, they call them moon-eyed people, particularly for their abilities to see at night and their large eyes. So this is kind of, I guess, an agreement with that sort of thing. It has a very large eye. I'm not sure if it's got the head turned this way, and that's the left eye, and the other eye's behind the branch, or what. I'm not really sure about orientation there. But you got to remember, this is taken from a long ways off, and it's a very good picture. It survives this kind of magnification very well. Okay, so that's the eye, and that's the beard. Quite an amazing thing. Got stoop shoulders. It's got a lot of snow. See where it's been sitting beneath this tree? It's been sitting on its behind. And it got surprised or something like that, and it bolted out from under the tree. And it's a series of photos as it comes out, and another series as it crosses over and goes behind another tree. And we'll look at those. But anyway, I wanted to do this little process, show you what it did, and show you the eye, and I'll zoom in on that eye some more. It's hard for the camera to stay focused. It's honey. The eye. And you know, I can even do better than that. I can throw a lasso around that if I wanted to look at it a little better. Throw a lasso around that. And then do some traditional brightening and contrast. Now you might see it a little better. No, so, you know, I think that photos like this get prejudged or get judged too quickly. Some people said that perhaps, you know, it looks like a stovepipe type of lower leg, and that makes them think it's a suit, and because they see that, they only give the whole thing about 30 seconds and they're on to something else. You got to give it a little more time than that and be a little more thoughtful in your analysis, so because you got to remember, this isn't the same conditions as we have over in the States. This is an extremely cold Siberia. There may be some conditions during the winter up there in the northern tiers, but Siberia is a cold place. It's got a heavy hair on its legs, and it's got ice on its legs. Let's see if I can find that photo. Let's see here. Okay, we got. I should have. Let's see. Igor. There we go. And we'll just look until we find the right one. I think it's going to be one of these standing up here. Yeah, this is the one. And if you look at this photo, you'll see ice on the feet and ice on this leg all the way up to here. And it's, you know, it's not just snow, it's ice. And when you get ice in there like that, and each follicle or each strand of hair has a coating of ice, then it's going to deform the hair. The hair is going to be bellowed out. So you know, it's only a photo. It's only an instant of time. It's not going to do the same things for analysis that a video or film will do. But in a very good photo, it will tell you an awful lot. And this is good enough to see individual hairs, even at this distance. See the foot bottom. You can see the snow on the toes and that sort of thing. So I'm pretty impressed with them. That's all for now. We'll talk about some more later. I thank you for your time.